Next traction failure is first notch autoregression without LSP. Previously, we have discussed about a traction failure in which first notch autoregression takes place but lamp LSP glows. And in this traction failure, first notch autoregression takes place but without LSP. So the abnormal sign goes like this. When MP is moved from 0 to N, then to plus, LSGR extinguishes, notch repeater deviates to 1, and immediately GR comes to 0 without glowing of LSP. Here also, GR progression takes place, but immediately regression also takes place and comes to 0. Like GR moves from 0 to 1 and back to 0 immediately. But the difference is there LSP glows and here LSP will not glow. Reasons: rear cap BL not locked properly. Rear cap BL not locked properly. Second, Q50 normally closed interlock on VE2 branch may be defective. Third one, Q51 normally open interlock on VE2 branch may be defective. Fourth one, QVCD relay might be in energized condition. QVCD relay might be in energized condition. So the troubleshooting: press BPT, push button switch for signaling lamp testing, BPT. Ensure LSP glows in any cap. Suspecting that LSP signaling lamp might have been fused, since we are experiencing first notch autoregression, it may be with LSP, but due to signaling lamp failure, it may be misleading us like without LSP. That's why to ensure that, we will press BPT and ensure LSP glowing in any cab. If LSP lamp is glowing normally, that means we are experiencing first notch autoregression without LSP only, then trip DJ lower pantograph and lock the BL box in front cab, that is leading cab. Now go to the rear cab, that means other cab. There operate BL key for 2 to 3 times, lock properly and try. Suspecting the interference of the rear cab BL, what we are doing is going to a rear cab after locking the leading cab BL box, there operating BL key for 2 or 3 times and finally locking it properly, and we will try. If still not successful, clean Q50 normally closed and Q51 normally open interlocks and try. Check QVCD. It should be in de-energized position. So if unsuccessful, after checking all these things, if they are all found normal, clear the section with manual operation of GR or from rear cab. If unsuccessful to find out the defect, clear the section with manual operation of GR or driving from a rear cab, following the instructions in force as per GNSR. If ZSMS is modified, work from rear cab or by manual operation of GR. There are 2 types of ZSMS connections nowadays, non-modified and modified. If ZSMS is modified, work from rear cab or by manual operation of GR. That is the only way. If ZSMS is not modified, wedge Q46 in de-energized condition and work with EEC operation. If your loco is provided with a non-modified ZSMS, you can work the train with EEC operation duly wedging Q46 in de-energized condition. And finally, inform to TLC at first opportunity. For better understanding, we will check the circuit also once. If we are driving from cab 1, that means BL1 is in unlocked condition, this interlock naturally will be in closed condition. So the trouble we are now discussing about is due to the rear cab BL, if it is not locked properly, you are driving from cab 1, then cab 2 BL should be locked properly. If it is locked properly, this interlock remains open. So if this interlock remains open, there will not be any interference from the rear cab. If there is any defect or if there is any problem of not locking the rear cab BL properly, this interlock remains closed and the battery supply comes this way and also this way. So one notch progression takes place through VE1 coil, and as and when one notch progresses, the supply from rear cab BL interlock comes like this, and rear cab MP will be on zero. So this interlock MP closes on zero, closes, and the supply continues like this, and will be waiting here at GR closes on 32 to 1 notch interlock. So as and when V1 coil energizes and one notch progression takes place, at first notch this interlock closes and VE2 coil gets supply. So immediately regression also takes place. This is what we call it as first notch auto regression without LSP due to rear cab BL interference. And also, this is one of the reasons. And the second reason we were talking about is defective Q50 normally closed interlock. As and when Q50 relay gets energized, its normally open interlock closes here and opens here. If this interlock is defective, that means if this interlock is defective, means it should be in open position, but if this interlock stays closed, remains closed, then the same trouble will be experienced. The supply from CCPT comes like this and will be waiting at this GR interlock until first notch is being progressed. As and when first notch progression takes place, this interlock closes and VE2 coil gets energized and the notch that we got will be regressed immediately. And the second one is this one, Q51 NO interlock. Since Q51 is already in de-energized position, this interlock should remain open. But if this interlock is defective means if it is remaining closed, same thing happens. Supply comes this way and reaches this interlock and waits. And whenever first notch progression takes place, immediately this interlock closes and again regression takes place. That's why if the first reason rear cab BL interference is there, we'll try by गोइंग टू रियर कैब ऑपरेटिंग बी एल की 2 to 3 टाइम्स एंड लॉकिंग इट प्रॉपरली. देन वील क्लीन द इंटरलॉक्स ऑफ Q50 एंड Q51 एंड द फोर्थ वन इज QBCD एक्शन. इफ QBCD VCD एक्शन और QBCD रिले इज इन एनर्जाइज्ड कंडीशन. इफ QBCD रिले इज इन एनर्जाइज्ड कंडीशन दिस NO इंटरलॉक क्लोजेस एंड द सप्लाई कम्स एंड वेट्स हियर. सो आफ्टर फर्स्ट नॉच प्रोग्रेशन दिस इंटरलॉक क्लोजेस एंड अगेन VE2 गेट्स एनर्जाइज्ड एंड रिग्रेशन टेक्स प्लेस. दैट्स वाई ऑल दीज फोर रीजन्स आर इन द टैप चेंजर कंट्रोल सर्क्यूट. सो द ट्रबल शूटिंग हैज टू बी डन इन दैट वे. So if ZSMS is modified, work from rear cab or by manual operation of GR. If ZSMS is not modified, wedge Q46 in de-energized condition and work with EEC operation. Inform TLC at the first opportunity. And this is the final traction failure that we are dealing. Thank you.